This is Paul with Shirley Fabrication in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Got a video I want to do right here for a good customer of mine, Mr. Mike McEwen. Mike already has had a Shirley, a bigger one. He's downsized a little bit, sold his other Shirley, so we kind of compressed this build. Very similar to his last build, compressed it, made it on a modified trailer, which is a good bit smaller, narrower, and everything. So that's what we got right here. We designed it, and gave me a liberty to do what I wanted to do from that point, and that's what I did. So this is a 24 by 55, okay? It's an elevated straight back cooker, has a hip roof on the main chamber right here, has a hip roof on the warmer. The warmer is elevated. So he's added four grates in the warmer. He's got a pull-out pan in the warmer he can direct grill with. He also has a half-inch thick firebox. So I'll tell you what I did on the chamber right here. I'm gonna tell you guys, anytime you have a fold-down shelf on the warmer, you can get the grate out. Just be cognizant of the fact that, you know, you need to not fling your door into that shelf if it's damp. So what I would do, or if you want to, you can pull this shelf up, it's a stainless shelf with a paper towel holder, pull it up, frame load it, lock it, okay? So here you go right here. He has three sets of grates right here, plenty of spacing on the grates. He has extra slots to jump grates around in. Has gaskets on the door. He has some drip bars on the doors right here also. Also, Mike sent me these gauges. You won't have any gauges like it. Doubt you could get them. He has this through the company he used to work for or still works for. Huge gauges, man, they look good. They're Rochester gauges, which is high, very, very high-end gauges. So come back right here. Also on the doors, I have welded on locking tab where he can hang a lock. Because believe it or not, there are fools out there that will get your grates out. They have nothing better than to do than steal. So they just don't make sense. But anyway, right here, here's the warmer. Right here, it is an elevated warmer, which is 36 inches from here to here. Has a hip roof on, gives a little more room on the top rack. So you got four grates. Elevated warmers don't come with four grates. All warmers come with two grates. You can add grates from that point to however many you want. Anyway, plenty of room in here, plenty of room. This pan here comes out and locks. You can direct grill in this. Again, our warmers are absolutely positively the most versatile warmers on America. In America, they're not only a warmer, they are a cooker. You can direct grill in here if you want to do a cook, just a small cook. You can take this out, use this pan to catch your drippings in. You can take that pan out, take both of them out. There is a heat deflector in there that's removable. You can open the damper, which is on the back side of the cooker. I'll show you in a minute. Damper on the back side of the cooker. You can put live fire from your firebox into the warmer. You can also, in conjunction with that, put heat from the main chamber and draft out the warmer. These can be used as a coal smoker, as a warmer, just to warm with, as a grill, as a pizza oven, as a numbers and numbers of things. You can use it as a cooker in conjunction with the main chamber, cooking a little bit less on the temps in here. If you're 300 on the main chamber, you can easily get 250 in here, you know, whatever. If you want to get 250 in there, you can get 225 in there. Some people get them even by fooling them with their dampers. It's just what you've got to learn to run the cooker. Very easy to run. Anyway, here that is. Close this up. All the gauges have eyebrows on them. That they look cool, and then they're there. That's what he wanted, so that's what he ordered. Right here, you have a ash pan comes out right here. You also have a big fire basket. I put higher sides on Mike's fire basket at a quarter inch thick plate. That's just what I wanted to do. I had some drops laying around, that's what I did. So that'll hold as much wood as he needs on this 55, and he can roll right there with it. So, back here on the back side. Come on, Sharon. Here is your dual damper system right here. So you can put, you can close your main stack or pinch it, come straight through here, open this damper, open the warmer damper, draft all the way through, or you can completely close that stack. A lot of guys do and draft all the way through. You can use them both. It just depends on what you want to do. You can start tweaking that open, okay, and putting some live fire from the firebox up in there. But you do have a deflector to help disperse the heat. So you got that. Yep. Custom fenders made right here in our shop. I can take a sledgehammer and hit these fenders and they still gonna be a fender after I get through with them. Has a Shirley spare tire cover right here. So that's on there. It has locks on the back to run some cables through. We'll lock that down. It has the basket that runs all the way around, comes through here. I did all this. Some of it I put plate in, some of it I put wire in. I did this where he'd have plenty of room for whatever he wants to use it for. So you've got umbrella holder here, flag umbrella holder here. You've got one right here. LED lights encased in boxes. Grease fittings on your hinges. Keep your hinges greased. I don't care if you over grease them. Keep your hinges greased. Okay? Sometimes after paint, you'll have to take a nail and put right here on this little ball. Push down in there. Keep your hinges greased. Service your cooker. I can look at your cooker and within 2 minutes tell you, have you taken care of your cooker? Did you clean the bathroom? Have you swept your ashes out of the firebox? Have you maintained that cooker? Do you clean it on occasion? Very simple for me to look and say, he ain't took care of it. So, all right, come back over here. All stainless steel, cool touch hinges, not chrome. Again, fold down shelf, come around here. Big, long shelf. Mike did not want the backsplash. So his pants, he set up here and go right under their waist. He did not want the backsplash. His last cooker did not have the backsplash. But this one runs all the way to the front. This shelf right here you go. Boom. That right there goes up, folds up, right there. Has a grease drain where if he wants his grease out, boom, there it is right there. He can move that, flip it. It's all about, did you think about what you were doing? Did you make it easy for your customer? Have you discussed with your customer? You know, I'll tell them options. I'd never push options on anybody because if they don't get any options, I'm cool with that. I can build it faster, quicker, and still make money on it. When you start getting all these options, yeah, they cost money because they cost me time, effort, and everything else. It's a custom cooker then. All our cookers are custom. But when you get into custom cooker, it's like building a custom house. Go get you a house for $110 or $120 a square foot, or get you a custom house for $230 a square foot. What do you want? That's all it boils down to. So again, right up here, it has a removable tongue. It also has a safety for people that don't know how to put in the thing in the receiver. It's got that. It's got the chain for it somewhere. What did I do with that chain, Jeff? Here it is. Got a chain right here for Mike. So we'll put that down there on the floor. LED lighting, like I said, the lights, I checked the light, has custom wheels and tires right here with center caps. Okay, turn around, Chair. Come here, baby. Look, see this wheel and tire? This is what we got now. There's a little difference in them. This is a newer wheel and tire. Those look beautiful, these look beautiful. Look at me, guys, it's what you can get. We have a hard time getting stuff. And we order 50, 75, 75, 100 at a time. And then, you know, it's like pulling teeth to get anything. All right, that pretty much covers this cooker right here. Jam up cooker, 2455, elevated straight back cabinet model, hip roofs on chamber, hip roofs and warmer, elevated warmer, half inch firebox, stainless shelf runs all the way to the front, basket that does all the way wrapping around, locks on the doors, eyebrows on the gauges. What else do you want? Big basket to wrap, it's highly custom built. It looks slick, it's slick, slick, slick. All right, now let me get off that a minute. Back to this, Tyler's email got hacked, okay? Last week. He has shut his email down. He had not been getting emails from people. People sent money, transferred money. I don't know, somebody in Congo probably sitting there with the money smoking a blunt. I don't know what they're doing. But anyway, it chaps my backside. I ain't even gonna get into it because I will say an awful, awful thing. But anyway, what I think they ought to do to them, and it ain't pretty. Do not send me any email to Shirley Fabrication. It was supposed to be shut down. I looked on it today. I don't hardly use Shirley Fabrication email anyway. If you send one to me, I ain't answering it. I ain't finna answer it. No, you ain't finna hack me. No. I'm not gonna do it. Tyler's is down, okay? Don't send the email to me for Tyler and expect me to email back through that email. It's not gonna happen. I had a couple a while ago. I spoke with Tyler at the shop. He said, tell them I will get back with them hopefully in a few days. He's got lawyers involved in this. He's got the police report. He's got everything going on. So, okay, he's got guys doing the email for him. So once he gets that straightened out, he will contact you back. I'm not getting in the middle of anything on that. I did, out of courtesy. I talked to him about the emails. I talked to him. I got a text. If you want to text message me, I'll answer that text. I'll answer that text, but I'm going to pull some DNA out of your backside because I don't know who you are. You ain't going, you ain't doing that to me. I get so mad when I think about it. What a freaking idiot. What else do they have to do besides hack somebody's email? And you know what? You're going to pay for it, maybe not in this lifetime, but the next, you're going to be in a devil's hell. And I hope you are. But anyway, all right, guys, I'm going to let that go now. I'm off of that. Hacked off about it. Yes, I am. I'm high strung anyway. I drank a lot of coffee this morning. I got to go do night shift tonight. I'm fixing to dress up in my dang work clothes and come out here and put a back on this straight back cooker. Might put a firebox on it. I'm going to sleep an hour and a half, go do 12 at the refinery, get up in the morning, sleep 3 hours, get up, get back on cookers. 62 years old, needing shoulder replacement. I don't have no use for nobody that won't freaking work. Get off your backside. Don't give me your problems. Get off your backside and work. All right. God bless y'all all. Yep, I am who I am. I am who I am. That's exactly right. Ain't gonna change for nobody. I'm out of here.